Fishing with the zinger takes place using four effective methods. The first is to cast out sideways, working the lure back towards you with a lift-drop motion. Reel in slack line on the drop. With this method, you can fish the surface or any depth right on down to the bottom. Another method is to simply lower the lure down until the desired depth is reached, then impart a steady lift-drop motion. Give the zinger full slack line on the drop. This creates a rotary action which draws the fish to the zinger. Yet another method is to let the zinger down through deep water bait fish concentrations while imparting slight tension on the line as it spools off. This makes the zinger spiral down, much like cut plug herring. If any speed change occurs, set the hook. Failing a strike on the drop, crank up fast, then repeat the descent. The final method is trolling, varying your engine speed until a steady thumping action is imparted on the rod tip. Extra weights and flashers may be added as you wish. Single hooks are preferred when trolling. We recommend you use a half and 1.5 ounce zingers in lakes and streams with 8 to 14 pound line. For larger lakes in salt water, use 1.5, 2.5, and 4.5 ounce zingers with 15 to 20 pound line. All trout and steelhead voraciously attack zingers. Fish the deep pools within 1 foot of the bottom. Also, fish tight to the vertical sides of the carved out pools and just in front of the tailouts. Trouts in lakes can be caught by casting from shore in likely drop-offs where streams enter or exit. When fishing lakes by boat, use the vertical lift-drop method beneath the boat. Again, fish the drop-offs and where streams enter or exit the lake. This method is also extremely effective on walleye, pike, and all varieties of bass, including stripers. Larger lake trout or mackinaw attack 1.5 and 2.5 ounce zingers in pearl white or perch colors. Fish the thermoclines or locate schools of mackinaw on a quality depth sounder. For saltwater fish near the surface, toss 1.5 ounce zingers into them or work it shallow beneath the boat. This method is very effective for cohos or silvers, black sea bass, dorado, barracuda, and all types of tuna and mackerel. For deeper feeding fish, such as chinook or kings, fish from 60 to 240 feet deep using the 2.5 ounce zinger. Fish just above haystacks of bait fish on the bottom or just beneath suspended clouds of bait fish using the lift drop method or by spiraling up and down through bait masses as previously demonstrated. For halibut, lingcod, rockfish, and all bottom fish, use 2.5 or 4.5 ounce zingers. For bottom fish, let the zinger down until it reaches the bottom, reel up 3 cranks, commence the lift drop motion, then be prepared to set the hook.
What do you got your goggles for? Oh, it's my depth sounder. Come here. That's it.
All right.
Oh, yes, he's a beauty.
You want a hand netting it?
Oh, no. I've got my own net. Fine fish! Got my trusty net here!
Oh yeah, look at that. Well, I think it's just about time.
Zingers are extremely effective no matter what method you use. You can even limit out on salmon free-floating 4 miles offshore wearing only a life jacket and long johns, if you're so inclined. We, the makers of the Zinger, as well as the folks at this fine store, value you as a customer. We want to give you the best possible results when you go fishing. Give the Zinger a chance to make your next day out fishing the best ever. For more information on the Zinger, the deadly sonic lure, call or write the Jigs Up Lure Corporation, Courtney, BC, Canada. Introduce yourself to the Zinger, a lure which time and time again lives up to its reputation as a deadly sonic lure. The Zinger needlefish and the Zinger anchovy both produce amazing results when it comes to catching fish wherever in the world they're used. The Zzinger anchovy is designed to represent deep-bodied bait fish, such as herring, alewives, shad, stickleback, smelt, minnows, or anchovies. And the narrower needlefish zinger imitates the slimmer bait fish, such as candlefish, sand lance, sand eel, and the needlefish itself. Both of these lures use hydrosonic waves to attract and even annoy fish into striking. Since, for the most part, the predominant bait fish in freshwater are deep-bodied in shape, the zinger anchovy becomes the more popular choice of the two. The fish we'll see caught today were all caught using the perch-colored half-ounce zinger anchovy. Using a lift-drop motion on the rod, the line slackens, causing the zinger to rotate, creating the waves that attract the fish from both inside and outside of the fish's sight range. The zinger effectively increases your fishing range many times more than those of conventional lures. To rig the lure, run an 8 to 14 pound line through both the lure and the rubber bumper that's included in each package. Then finish with the treble hook provided. For those preferring single hooks, we recommend you use a snell knot to attach. Further, we suggest the placement of a quarter inch piece of spaghetti tubing cut at a 45 degree angle on the hook end. This assures that the single hook positions itself in its most efficient position, that being in line with the zinger. Spaghetti tubing can be found where drip irrigation supplies are sold, or failing that, other similar types of fine tubing can be used. When single hooks are required, we suggest the use of a high quality sharp hook, such as the Eagle Claw Laser Sharp, size 1-0 on a half ounce perch colored zinger. Are highly successful on all freshwater fish when used in the three following techniques: casting, jigging, and trolling. When casting from the lake shore or river's edge, give the zinger action by lifting and dropping the tip of the rod by about 2 feet. This same lift-drop action is used while jigging directly below the boat or while ice fishing. Fishing, be sure to try your skill at varying depths, deeper in midday and shallower as it gets dark. If, like in this example, you're fishing a deep pool, it's important to be sure to fish all parts of it, the head, tails, and sides.
This half-ounce zinger is just deadly on steelhead and all kinds of trout, and I'd kind of like to give you a demonstration on how good it is. For steelhead fishing, I'd recommend using Polaroid sunglasses and wear a dark shirt and try to keep the sun at your back. The zinger is perfectly adept to fishing rivers and streams that carry steelhead that have deep pools cut out of them, such as this run we have here. This is a typical northwest steelhead stream. It's got cuts through it and gravel bottoms, and it's the kind of place you'd like to use a half-ounce zinger, where the people with wool and bait can't really fish all the different profiles of the pool. The zinger will fish the whole thing. You want to fish roughly the bottom 1 foot of the pool where the steelhead are lying. these steelhead hang around the sheer cliffs of these streams that are cut out. And this half-ounce zinger is a great way to fish those cliffs, because you can fish the whole cliff up to down. Oops. What do we got here? There's our first steelhead right there. Nice jumper. It's pretty common that you catch a steelhead right off the bat on this zinger. It's just a totally amazing lure. It just drives fish crazy. I could tell you what's making these fish go wild over this zinger, but if I did that, all the other lure manufacturers would be copying it.
Casted out about maybe 100 feet. Hey, there's a good thing. Motor doesn't work.
For the trollers, zingers are the ideal weapon. If fish are rising to the surface, we recommend trolling the zinger fast and with no weight.
Kind of a drop-off on this lake. We'll just cruise along the drop-off. Go right around the lake.
A steady bounce of the tip of the rod lets you know when you've reached the ideal trolling speed. For deeper fish, add appropriate weight to position the lure at the desired depth.
It's got a great thing. First trout on the troll with the half-ounce zinger. Trolling's not quite as fun as casting for them, but it's effective sometimes. Pan-sized trout. Now I'll just lift him in here before he gets off, which he did. Fortunately, it was in the boat. Come on out, you. There's a, let's see, what is this? That's a typical cutthroat. Slippery and pretty good fighter, and these cutthroats really like the zingers. My favorite color is the perch color of zinger in the half-ounce size, and we get these guys up to 10 pounds on the zinger. They're quite a voracious fish. They eat a lot of small fish, and they really like that zinger because that's a small fish to them. And they like it, they go for it.
Thank you.
focus primarily on the steelhead, cutthroat, and rainbow trout, zingers have been proven deadly on most other freshwater species, such as walleye, mackinaw, kokanee, pike, and all varieties of bass and trout. In addition, coho and chinook salmon are readily taken on zingers as much as in freshwater as in salt.